Good morning!
Morning!
Or afternoon or evening or...
Whenever you're watching this.
Hello! Hello to you!
And you!
And you!
And you! And you! And you!
Morning! So it's the last week of March.
Which is crazy.
That's insane. We're like, where did March go?
I have no idea.
Blinked and ta-da! But you know what that means?
What does that mean?
Means that we... We are almost at Easter.
Easter is next weekend, and I'm so excited. Yeah. I love Easter. It is such an exciting time because for the world, you know, there's Easter eggs, and there's Easter bunny, and there's chickens everywhere, whatever. But, like, for us as Christians, we know that Easter is a very big deal to us.
Huge, huge. And so we're going to jump into Palm Sunday stuff right after worship, but we have a few announcements first.
Yes.
So, the first one is next weekend, Easter weekend, we will have something called Easter Jam on our YouTube channel. It will be premiering. We will have our
normal Sunday
stuff. You will see our faces, but as well, we will have Easter Jam. And so, it's something you can watch with your whole family. The Easter story, there's some worship. It's really, really awesome. And so, We would love if you guys wanted to join us and watch that. And there's some other Easter content that your parents can get on our website.
Yes. Other reminder is that usually you guys would have had March break, but because of the COVID restrictions, they had changed March break to April break, which I'm not sure if we're calling it April break or spring break, whatever it is. We have some exciting things for you to be able to do with your family on April break. So you can check out our website, and we are going to have some really fun stuff for you guys to do.
Yeah, and so let's jump into worship, but maybe I'll pray first, and then we can transition. So Lord, thank you for today. Jesus, I thank you as we prepare our hearts to think about how you came to earth, and you died, and you rose again, and how that completely changes our lives, gives us hope and joy. And I just pray as we prepare to think about that and reflect on that, this week, that you would be with us, and we just thank you that we are able to gather and learn about you, and so would you, just continue to be the center of our lives. Amen.
Amen.
You're my calm in the chaos, my peace in the war. You speak light into darkness. You tell me I'm yours. Only you, Jesus, are in control. You are my every heartbeat, every breath that I breathe. You're all I need, you're all I need. You speak life, sing your love over me. You're all I need, you're all I need. Caught up in your captivating, never fail. Take my brokenness and make me whole. Only you, Jesus, are in control. Take my brokenness and make me whole. You are my every heartbeat, every breath that I breathe. You're all I need. All I need. Speak life, sing your love over me. You're all I need. You're all I hold.
I love the idea and just the reminder that, like, God is all we need.
Yeah.
Even when things are crazy and, like, for example, okay, so in this last, I don't know, like, year of COVID and being on my computer and, like, being at home and lots of other people being at home, the internet was not always as rapid as I would like it to be. And so it really tested my patience. Like, there was times I would be, I don't know if you guys know this, but, like, I'm pretty animated when I talk. And sometimes there would be times where people would be like, we just missed everything you said. And I'm like, I was so into it. And, like, so then you have to re-say it and try and be as, like, excited and crazy. It's just, it was so frustrating to me.
I think this whole pandemic has tested so many of our patients. Like, it's been a tough year, and it's been a full year now that we have lived with and in through a pandemic. Mm-hmm. And so the fact that we have had to come up with new ways to celebrate, new ways to do work, new ways to, I don't know, communicate with one another, it's for sure testing my patience.
Yeah, and you know what? Like, I just find, I just feel so blah sometimes when the waiting seems like,
yeah.
Or like things are just taking so long. It feels like,
I totally agree, but I feel like what if we could find things to still be excited about and still celebrate even while we are waiting for this thing to change and be over and for life to get back to some semblance of normalcy? Mm-hmm. What if there are things that we could still like celebrate?
Yeah. Yeah, like, I'm sure there is, but I think sometimes it's hard to celebrate when you're, like, frustrated or feeling blah or heavy, and, like, it's hard to get your head kind of out of the weeds, I like to say, yeah. And, like, celebrate and see all the things, the other things that are happening while you wait. And so today, we are going to talk about people who had to choose to get their heads out of the weeds. And, like, as they had anticipation for what was happening, but they had to wait.
Yeah. And that's the thing about waiting is that, like, it's not always when the circumstances are ideal. Waiting can happen when the circumstances aren't ideal.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to jump into today's story, and we are going to learn a little bit more about how to keep celebrating, keep being excited about something, even when the circumstances aren't ideal.
Hello, everyone. I'm Brandon.
And I'm John.
And welcome to the So-and-So Show. John, what is going on?
Oh, Easter is next week. Pretty big day.
I'll say.
And I cannot wait to celebrate it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, just look at this chocolate bunny. He's just begging me to eat him.
I'm so chocolatey and delicious. Have just a nibble, please.
Hey, I guess we could celebrate a week early.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Happy Easter!
No, I'm good. I know.
Great! Who knew you didn't have to wait to celebrate Easter?
Yeah. I mean, who says we can't celebrate other holidays early, too?
Let's do it now!
Yeah!
Happy Arbor Day!
Hey, Mom. Happy Mother's Day. Oh, you're welcome. Hey, can you put Dad on the phone? Hey, Dad, happy Father's Day. You're welcome.
Happy Canada Day, eh?
Hey, bro. Happy Brother's Day. Yeah, you're welcome.
Happy Independence Day.
Yeah. Hey, Jeff. Happy Second Cousin Removed Day. It's a thing. Yeah, you're welcome.
Happy Bastille Day.
Oh, fromage!
Hey, Sparky! Who's a good dog? Happy Dog's Day!
You're welcome.
Can I get another hot dog?
Sure, buddy.
Happy Labor Day!
Trigger!
Merry Christmas.
Oh, you shouldn't have! Are you sure this is how you celebrate Boxing Day?
Hmm?
Oh!
3, 2, 1, happy 2022!
What are you
Oh man, 6 more weeks of winter.
That was fun.
Yeah. Oh, one more thing to celebrate.
What's that?
It's Bible story time with Kellen.
Yes!
Hey guys, whoa! You guys all right?
Yeah, we just celebrated a year's worth of holidays in 3 minutes.
That sounds exhausting.
Yeah. I guess it kind of was.
So I guess you've already done Palm Sunday then.
Wait, that's today.
How could we forget?
How about this? How about you celebrate by helping me tell the Bible story?
Absolutely.
Awesome. Well, here's a little puppet head theater. Jesus and his disciples were on their way to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover. Jesus told 2 of his disciples, "Go to the village ahead of you. As soon as you get there, you'll find a donkey tied there along with her colt. Uh-huh. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, say that the Lord needs them."
Oh.
You see, hundreds of years earlier, one of God's prophets, Zechariah, said the Messiah would come to Jerusalem riding on a donkey. That prophecy was about to come true. When the disciples went to Jerusalem, they found the donkey just like Jesus said.
Oh, here it is. Perfect. Come on, little guy. I'll just get you here. All right.
Hey! What are you doing with my donkey?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just, what was I supposed to say? Right. The Lord needs him.
The Lord? Why didn't you say so?
I just did.
Well, please, by all means, take him away.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Come on, little guy. Here we go. Oh, and thank you.
No problem.
Okay, whoa. Slow down. Whoa, here we go.
So they took the donkey back to Jesus and placed their cloaks on the donkey for Jesus to sit on.
Here you go.
And here's one.
Nathaniel, you got your cloak? And one more.
Jesus got on the donkey and headed to Jerusalem. When word spread that Jesus was coming, a crowd gathered and spread their cloaks all on the ground, while others cut palm tree branches and spread them on the road.
My cloak for ye, sir.
Hosanna!
It's the Messiah. He's coming.
Hosanna!
He's getting closer. Here he comes.
Jesus rode into Jerusalem, and he was greeted with cheers and shouts of hope and wonder. They wondered, could this be the Messiah that they had been promised all those years ago?
Hosanna to the Son of David!
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord!
Hosanna in the highest heaven! Yes.
The entire city was amazed at what was happening. Now, they weren't 100% sure that Jesus was the one that they'd been waiting for, but they still celebrated.
It's Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth.
The end. That's one of my favorite stories in the Bible. Everyone was waiting for a savior. They think they have one, so they celebrate. Even though he's on the back of a donkey, they treat him as a king.
Yeah, pretty incredible.
But over the course of the week leading up to what we call Easter, there would be a lot of pain. Jesus, the man they thought was their king, would be arrested and sentenced to death. It was a roller coaster of emotion.
So what happened after that?
Well, I think a lot of us know what happened after that. And while we can still celebrate the hope the Easter story gives us today and every day, you'll have to wait to hear the rest of the story next week.
Fair enough. Hey, thanks, Kellen.
Nope. Thank you, guys.
Later.
See ya.
Great story.
I know. The people had been waiting so long for a savior, they must have been thrilled.
I know, yeah, and they still didn't know exactly who Jesus was.
They didn't know the crazy, turn-your-world-upside-down miracle that was about to happen.
So they still had to wait and wonder.
Just like us sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, check this out. Reveal the question!
What are you waiting for right now? John?
Lunch!
After the show, buddy.
Oh, right.
But what else? Are you waiting for news about a test, about whether or not your parents are going to have to move for work? Maybe you're waiting for God to answer a prayer.
Oh, wow. Yeah. What? Those are really thoughtful.
Thanks. Waiting for lunch is good, too.
Yeah, lunch is good.
Just know that whatever you're waiting for, you don't have to wait to celebrate all the good stuff.
That's right, right. You can celebrate all the holidays in one day. Let's do it.
Oh, wait. We've already done the whole year.
We haven't done next year.
It's true. Talk about it with each other. What are you waiting for right now? And we'll see you next time on The So-and-So Show.
To the future.
Yeah.
It can be really hard to celebrate or be joyful while we're waiting and while we have anticipation. Because sometimes we're just like, let's go. Like, we don't want to actually, like, stop and be present and try and enjoy or even learn. Like, grow and have our character built while we wait. Mm-hmm. And so it can be really hard. It's hard for me, it's hard for you, might be hard for you guys. And so one thing that I think is so important is to see that there are things worth celebrating in the hard times. So maybe like there are things going on in your life that feel like really hard and difficult, but if I can challenge you to lift your head above the weeds, so to speak, and just see what God's doing around you. Maybe someone was kind enough to give you some of their lunch because you forgot to pack yours. Or maybe, I don't know, maybe your sibling gave you extra screen time. Or like, I don't know, like little things, but something to celebrate in the hard times.
Absolutely. And you guys are actually going to all have a chance to be able to do this next week because we are celebrating Easter. And so as we celebrate Easter, we celebrate this exciting thing that God went to the cross and died for all of our sins so that he could resurrect and we could have eternal life in him. That's what we're celebrating next week. And so things do not look how they used to look like. Things are different. Maybe you can't see all the family that you want to see. Maybe you can't come to church and celebrate all the things. Mm-hmm. But you have a chance to be able to celebrate the good news of what Jesus has done for us in mm-hmm. circumstances that don't always feel ideal. Mm-hmm. And so we challenge you that this week and all of the weeks to mm-hmm. really find things that are worth celebrating even while we wait.
Yes. So we will see you next week for Easter, and we will chat all about that next week. And so we cannot wait.
We'll see you then. Bye.